So I've spoken a bit about consensus algorithms and how they are used to help verify transactions and individual blocks. Now I'm going to dive deeper into the two types of consensus algorithms and detail how each of them work. In the last video, I described how the mining process works and how a miner is able to win the round and add the next block to the blockchain. So how does someone win the round? By solving the proof of work consensus algorithm. When solving the block problem, the goal is to generate a block with a hash that meets a certain requirement, or hashing difficulty. No advanced math or computation is involved in solving this puzzle. What they're actually trying to do is be the first miner to come up with a 64-digit hexadecimal number, or hash, that is less than or equal to the target hash. It's basically guesswork to try different values until they find the right hash that matches the goal. We know the output, so we have to find different hash input combinations and see what is generated to see if it matches the output. Miners are given a nonce, which is some random number, but they can have a starting point to guess the correct hash. Initially, 1 in 16 hashes would have worked, but every 2 weeks or so, the hashing throughput of the network grows sufficiently, and the target is reduced in size. Each shift from the target to the new target represents 16 times more work because it is a hexadecimal base 16 number and will therefore take longer and use much more computing power and have a higher hash rate. Proof of work is the algorithm used by Bitcoin, Ethereum, and many other blockchains. One big downside to proof of work is that mining consumes a lot of energy. In fact, the amount of energy currently being consumed on mining is equivalent to the amount of energy that some countries use. So because of this, some communities such as Ethereum want to use proof of stake as a more eco-friendly option for consensus. Next up, let's talk about proof of stake. This is another method of creating a new block in a blockchain. With proof of stake, the blockchain network aims to achieve consensus from those who lock up some of their stake and the ecosystem as a deposit. This means there is no competition to be the quickest one to solve the current block problem, where the block is determined by an algorithm based on the user's stake in the network. So here there are no miners, but instead validators. Validators are chosen based on a selection algorithm that takes their state into account. The validator gets the right to create the next block, and validators will lose their stake if they misbehave and abuse their power in some way. There is no reward for creating the new block. Rather, the validator receives a transaction fee that is somewhere between 2 to 15% of the transaction. As Ethereum moves towards 2.0, they will decide to replace their proof of work consensus method with proof of stake. And once Ethereum moves to proof of stake, it's likely Bitcoin will follow suit soon after.